Good morning, children. How are you all? So let's begin our lesson. Question answers from the lesson Ranga's Marriage. Here we go. First one. Comment on the influence of English, the language and the way of life, on Indian life as reflected in the story. What is the narrator's attitude to English? So the answer. British not only brought the industrialization alone, but carried their culture, religion and language also with them when they came to India. There were many other dynasties like the Mughal, the Delhi Sultanate, etc., ruling India for centuries before the British. However, the British rule has left with us an impact which seems to last forever. One of the biggest influences of the British reign, that is the British rule, is the English language. We got that language from them. From who? From the British. We look down upon who do not know the English language. Yes. It is good that we learn English as it is an international language, and these days if you want to get into some good job, English is a must. It is required. But we should not consider it as a status symbol. No, it is not a status symbol, but you should know that language. This particular attitude of Indians who consider knowing English as the status symbol is reflected in the story. The narrator of the story, Sharma, highlights in the story the false notions, ideas. Okay, highlights the false notions of the people that learning English would change a person completely. It is not so. That was the thinking of the people in those days. He confirms that there is no change he can observe in the expression of Ranga. So that is confirmed. He has not changed at all. Ranga seems to be following the very traditional way of greeting, saying namaskar and other common gestures like bowing down and touching the feet of elders. So Ranga has kept all the traditions and customs alive. He follows all the customs, all the traditions. He must be emphasizing his point of view that learning a foreign language has nothing to do with one's culture or tradition, as Ranga continues to follow the traditional way of greeting in spite of learning English. So, though Ranga is very versed in English, he went to Bangalore to study, he has come back, but he doesn't deviate from his customs and traditions. He believes firmly in his customs and traditions. Now, if one is educated, one knows English, doesn't it mean that one should deviate from one's own customs and traditions? No, it doesn't happen. So, should not happen. So, children, note down this question. Then, let's move on to the answer also. We'll move on to the next question. The second question. Astrologers' perceptions are based more on hearsay. Whatever they hear from others is hearsay. And conjecture than what we learn from the study of the stars. It is based more on hearsay. Comment with reference to the story. Okay, now the answer. People of India still believe in astrology even in these modern times. There are so many people who believe in astrology even today, you know. Astrologers work on the principle that the position of stars and planets influence human affairs. In fact, nobody can make calculations of the stars. No, the astrologers believe that it all depends on the movement of the stars, the celestial bodies and all that. Okay, so calculations of the stars and planets, but astrologers pretended to do so. But they know that, but they pretend as if they do not know, and they don't do that. Okay, most of these predictions are based upon the information supplied earlier by someone. Now, some information has been supplied to them by some other astrologers long back, and they follow that. That is what happens generally. Simple-minded people are taken in by such claims and end up paying a hefty sum, huge amount of money, hefty sum to the astrologers. Now, people, there are so many people even today, they run after the astrologers, they run to them, and you know, they think that the stars will shine. They will be very successful in life if they follow things told by them. Very few astrologers might possess the real knowledge. It is a fact. Very few of them have that actual knowledge in them. Why? Most of them are dupes. Dupes, they try to fool people. Cheats. Most of them are dupes, means they are cheats. They try to fool the people. That is what most of them do. Most of them are dupes who are out to make money. Most of them, they're just making their profession to earn money, nothing else. In the story, the narrator sets up the local astrologer to give such predictions that will help his plan of getting Ranga married to Ratna. So that is Shyama's plan. He tells everything to the astrologer Shastri beforehand, that you make it in such a way, do it in such a way that the plan materializes into marriage. That was their plan. They had already planned about it. Okay, so it was like that. He meets the astrologer beforehand. I already told you. And tutors him in all that he wants him to say. He meets Shastri and tutors him, teaches him. You talk like this, you say that. Why? So that Ranga is convinced. He agrees for that marriage. That was their intention. Shyama's intention especially. People like Ranga, though they have lived in the town and are educated, yet they believe in such superstitions and base their decisions on the conjectures done by such astrologers. Whatever they do, they blindly follow. The narrator pokes fun, makes fun at all such gullible people. Who are the gullible people? Who blindly believe the astrologers and blindly do all the things told to them. They are gullible people. He makes the reader see the ridiculousness of the situation and hence learn the value of rationalism in life. Now, one always must have a rational outlook, rational approach to life. You must always have your logical reasoning for everything. Okay? So, this also you have to go through this answer, write down, go through. Now, the third one. Indian society has moved a long way from the way the marriage is arranged in the story. Discuss. A lot of changes have happened in today's world. Yes. The answer. The student should prepare the answer on their own. A modern answer is given for their reference. So this is just a modern sample. You have to prepare your own answer. The story Ranga's marriage reflects the traditional system of arranged marriages. These days the scenario has changed completely. Youngsters do not want to stay dependent on their parents or elders for choosing their life partner. Yeah, these days once children grow up, they are educated, settled in life, well settled in life, they think they can take and make their own decisions, including marriage. Ranga, in the story Ranga's marriage, we find that the initiative for the wedding of Ranga and Ratna was taken by the narrator. The initiative was taken by Shyama the narrator. Now the boys and girls themselves take the lead and decide themselves who they want to marry. However, there are cases the parents and the society do not support such marriages. Society does not support, sometimes the society also does not support, but things have changed, no doubt about that. Okay, now they do not support, but the Indian law approves it. Indian law approves it, says okay. Also, marriages at a very young age have been discouraged. Below 18, you cannot get married. As people are aware of the fact that certain sense of maturity is required for the marriage. Everybody is aware these days. Maturity is a must. You must try to understand things. Then only they can make your own decisions in life. Because these are very important decisions that one has to make. So it is like that. Children, that's all for today. So note down all the questions and answers. Go through.